Chef Jason Prendergast is here to show us what abundance you brought from the restaurant. And what are we cooking today, Chef?
Well, thank you both. So we're excited to be here. So spring is in the air. It's finally sprung.
Yes.
So we're super excited about that. We have some beautiful blonde morels. We have some snap peas. We have some asparagus. We have some mint. We have some other softer herbs. So we have a lot of stuff going on here.
Yeah, so fresh veggies, herbs, all things that have kind of sprouted.
It's absolutely great. It's fantastic to be back in the market and we see everything green. So it's been a little brown and dismal lately, but now it's vibrant and exciting. So we're gonna start with an asparagus dish that I have by Sam. So our asparagus dish is pretty simple. So the beautiful part of it is, Sam's great. The beautiful part of it is our asparagus is treated simply. So what we do is we just kind of pan roast it with a little bit of olive oil.
Okay. You cut the asparagus different than when I do at home. So how is it?
You could kind of cut
it like that.
You can kind of cut it whichever way you want. Really, it's all about your feeling and kind of the emotion you have at that time in the day. So we just kind of do it on a little bit of a bias because we.
If I'm having asparagus, I'm mostly sad, probably.
That's a bad day.
I'm sure you'll make it more delicious than I would. That's why I'm sad.
So we cut it to fit in our bowls here that we use on the side dish.
Okay.
So this is our asparagus. We just simply sear with a little bit of olive oil and some gray salt.
What's gray salt?
Yeah.
It's a French sea salt that's finely ground for us. And then Sam, if you wouldn't mind putting a little bit of that soft egg dressing. So the inspiration behind the soft egg dressing was kind of hollandaise. Asparagus and hollandaise go hand in hand for the years.
Yes.
So we really touch base with heritage cooking.
Do you want more?
You can do a little bit more so you don't want to be
too much. All right.
There you go. You could kind
of
make it
hollandaise
reminds
me of a nice Easter brunch.
There you go. Well, asparagus and hollandaise is always a great thing.
Perfect.
And then we finish with a little bit of garlic breadcrumbs here.
Ooh.
So we take some panko, just toast it in a little bit of garlic oil, and simply plate that in our bowl. And if you would grab some of those soft herbs.
I will.
That Andy just threw off the table.
I just like to mess stuff up.
That's okay. It happens.
I'm a good dressinger. Is that a word?
Yes. You just made it one.
Plating.
You just made it one.
Here,
so you can go pretty heavy on that one. So we want it
because
these soft herbs add that spring flair to it where it's super light, delicious, and fresh kind of feeling, even though
fresh. And
fig's
about that, right?
Yeah.
Fig is all about family style, heritage cooking, the farmer's market, local seafood purveyors.
So because you guys are in Santa Monica, and Santa Monica also has a great farmer's market. Where are you looking for all of your produce? And seasonally, what are you specifically looking for to grab?
So seasonally, the thing about shopping at the farmer's market is...
Yeah, let us know, because I don't know how to do
one thing is, we feed our farmers. Every week we go on Wednesday. So we grab their attention no matter how big the line is.
Uh-huh.
So that immediately puts us to the front of the line. And
food does that.
Food does that.
Yeah.
So you have to taste everything. It's just kind of like walking around Costco. If I take the kids to Costco, Aiden and Addison, my children.
Samples are so good.
The samples, they like to do the samples.
Yes.
I do the same thing at the farmer's market. So we're always walking down the street, snacking on something, tasting what one farmer has versus the other. They all have a story to kind of tie into. So it's whichever one that kind of captures your heart is the one that we pick.
Wow. Are you there for a while?
Oh, yeah. We're there for a couple hours.
It's a
fun thing.
Taking pitches.
Yeah. What do you have? Okay, what's next?
So next is our snap pea dish. So we take a little bit of guanciale, which is cured pork jowl. We render that, which is a fancy term of throw it in the pan and let the fat come out.
Okay.
So then we don't have to add any more oil to it. And then we add our snap peas.
And you break off the ends of your snap peas.
We break off the ends, we trim it really fast. You could essentially do this. This is a good thing, again, with the kids, is to pull this off.
Good job for them.
It's a good job for them. There you go.
Is that who's working
snap peas
in your kitchen?
I wish. They kind of listen like my kids do sometimes. So again,
kind of listen.
We add some of our English peas that we pick and blanch.
Okay.
That's another good job for the kids.
As you're munching
really
on the
store.
Snap pea, I love it. And you mix the fat in with
it. I was just going to say, this is such a great recipe because it has that fat, which is going to give it flavor, but it also has fresh veggies in it, which is hard to get on both ends if you're not eating a steak and broccoli
or something. So it's kind of like you're cheating on your diet, right?
Yeah.
You're having vegetables, but you also have that pork fat in there. We throw a little bit of shallots inside there, too, just to give it that spring oniony flavor. And then again, a little bit more fresh herbs.
What is this?
That's mint.
That I can chew on.
That you can chew on too. So I'm gonna let you plate this one up because this is pretty simple.
Okay,
very easy.
Like the kids. That's about the
just
range
like
of
the
my
kids.
Cooking.
There you go. You could always
free also like the kids.
Also, your pans are a lot heavier than the ones I have at home.
I know they're very fancy.
Oh man, you could lift weights with this guy.
We try. Makes us have our New Year's resolution. So that's it. It's pretty simple.
And you mentioned, one more salt, because that's different from the gray salt.
So this is our Maldon sea salt, so this is the Irish sea salt. So then we just finish a little bit of
the
sea
flavors.
Salt on the top.
When can I eat these?
So simple. You can start right now
if
you like.
Okay. That's all you need to tell me.
So you mentioned seafood, and this has been staring at me.
This has been staring at you now.
Please.
So now we're going to switch this pot here.
Okay.
And I'm going to pull
Magic
a Julia
TV.
Child move and just move that
walk it right off the set.
Look at that. Right off the set. So here we have morels. So there's,
oh my gosh.
There's so many different types of morels. These ones we prefer are the blonde ones, which are mythical ones because they never have worms. And that's the worst thing you do is you want to start cutting the mushrooms and you see worms crawling out.
Wait,
it's
what?
Never a good thing.
I never knew that was a thing.
Why are these worm free?
Yeah.
So just it's a mythical creature that these
made.
Never have.
Oh, they're like sponges.
They're like soft, small sponges.
Okay. Ooh, like a loofah.
So how did you cook it?
So these ones we braised down in a little bit of butter. When I say a little bit, I mean a lot of butter.
Yes, that's Paladine often
style.
How it goes.
Some smashed garlic cloves and some thyme sprigs.
Okay.
And then we finish it with a little bit of chicken jus. So chicken jus, we take all our scraps, trimmings from chicken, bones, everything when we're breaking down chickens, roast those, and cover it with water and bring it down 8 times.
Mm-hmm.
And that gives us a really condensed sauce. And then we have our lovely fava beans, which I'll come to the back of our magic studio here.
You can see him in the bowl.
Oh, whoa! This is like something out of the Jolly Green Giant, or like when,
or Silence of the Lambs,
or
Silence of the Lambs, exactly.
The
yes, that's where they crawl up the big giant thing mm-hmm. with the giant.
Okay, so you put those in here.
So these you have to
open it. Is that
open it? Yeah.
Is this proper? How do we do this?
So this one.
Oh, you peel it.
You peel it.
I just want to see here because I can't really get that close, but I can. Sam.
Who is worse at this, me or your small children?
good, those are huge.
I put it in front, like put the kids in front of the TV with this one, so they'll do it for a little while. Give them like 8 or 9 minutes, and we'll get three done.
Raw.
Not so good.
Okay,
so
I won't try.
So these ones, we blanch them, and then you got to double shuck them, so they're never fun to do. So the exciting thing about spring is everything's green, but there's a lot of work to get done.
Yeah, there is.
So,
but by the magic of television,
by the magic
it's
of television,
already
we already have it cooked. So we blanch those, add it to our chicken jus, and then we have a little bit of ramps in there, which are wild spring leeks.
Mm.
So we pickle the green, or I'm sorry, we pickle the white ends, and then we just simply wilt the green ends in there, and then finish with a little bit of parsley.
This dish seems simple enough, but it has so many ingredients.
I know, you make it seem like it's so easy.
So the whole thing about having fun at home is, if you do some prep the day before, it makes your life a little less stressful. So
and
by
this
the time,
is a little different, though. When I'm going to the farmer's market, I'm pretty simple, like green vegetables, fruits, or whatever. How do you, where would I find those? How do I know what I'm getting seasonally?
So these ones, you'll see anything at the farmer's market is seasonal. So that's the good thing about the farmer's market is everything they have out there is what they're growing. And they even have signs that say in the background, we sell what we grow.
Okay,
love
so
it.
So that's the way you know you can trust them. And then one more thing we'll do is grab a plate here.
I dropped a pee.
It's okay, it happens. Thank God that's not really hot because she handed me the bottom.
What do you mean?
It's sands.
Oh, that smells.
It smells really good.
Delicious.
So simple, to the point, delicious.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sam, can I have the bottom of that pan again?
Yes, the bottom of it, sure. so this is where the scallops come in.
This is where the scallops come in,
right? Okay.
Did you say there was chicken broth in here?
There's a chicken jus in there. So
you've combined so many flavors, and now we're putting seafood on top.
But it all goes well together.
It really is nothing.
So these scallops won't taste like chicken, but they'll have a little hint of chicken. So we have our beautiful diver scallops. They're seared in a little bit of olive oil.
What's your key to searing a scallop? Because I always seem to either underdo it, overdo it. Whoop. How do I get a perfect sear on a scallop? Hey.
So super, super hot pan, but not too hot. So it's when you put it in,
like hand
your oils,
over, you can feel the heat coming off.
I mean, we touch our pan, so I wouldn't suggest that at home. It's probably not the best safe idea.
Yeah,
but when you see a little bit of smoke coming from your oil, then you know it's a good time.
Perfect.
So you just want to leave it sit there, and you could kind of see it caramelize on the sides.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you kind of know it's time to flip. So it's just a quick flip, and then you're done. And then here we have our delicious scallops with morels, ramps, and
suit yourself, guys. I'm
favas.
Plated for.
Wow. We're gonna take those back home with us because those are super expensive.
Yeah, how much would a large pot of those?
How much would a large
cost?
Pot? About that's about $350 right there.
Whoa!
So
oh my gosh.
That's something I suggest you go out and buy. I think they're about $40 in the store a pound. So
really,
it takes a little time. These are still coming. These are actually coming from the Midwest right now. They're coming from Portland, Oregon. So we'll start to see ours coming soon.
So that's why we go to Fig and have it prepared and bought and everything else for us.
Talking about going to Fig though, actually,
May
so
I
it's at
fork?
The yes, oh. you are. It's at the Fairmont in Santa Monica, and you might miss it if you don't, because it told me to go on a different street. You go into the hotel, which is glorious enough, and then in a little nook in the back is this adorable restaurant, and when you walk in, everything is just, it's a cool place to go. It's sort of like a hidden gem. When I walked in, I was like, I'm so glad I know this exists, because I feel like I'm in the know.
Impressive.
Like, I'm
friends.
The cool kid.
Yeah.
Like, oh, we'll go to this little spot, and then you go in, and it's just a gorgeous place. So thank you so much for coming in. You guys have breakfast, lunch, brunch, dinner, all the things.
7 days a week.
Awesome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for joining us on 5 Live. We'll be right back.